Hello. How are you all doing? I'm boiling. I'm so sorry that I didn't do a vlog yesterday. It was kind of my last Saturday with family before my treatment started, and I had family come up. It was a family birthday. So I just kind of let my hair down. Didn't think about cancer. Didn't think about nothing like that. I did, however, think about Henry. He's doing fine. He's miserable. Then again, thinking about if I had a corner on my head stopping me from getting to my favourite food and I wasn't allowed wet food and I had to have dry food, I would be upset too. Sneaky little fucker tried to get some pea and ham soup today. It's hilarious to watch, but not so fun if I have to clean his cone. Anyway, he's had ear drops. £28 for ear drops after a £180 bill for an operation. I wanted to cry. That vet has had a substantial amount of money off me this week. All in good. All in good. Mindy was there today. She's got oh God, she did say what it was, but I can't really say it because it was a hell of a mouthful. It is something to do with glands that flare up and cause a flare up on the skin, something like that. And that's what's causing her to over-groom and bite her skin and all stuff like that. So she cost us £88 today. Like I said, I'd rather pay that. Know they're safe, know they're healthy, know they're happy. Than, spend that money on anything else and know that they're upset and happy and not living their life to the fullest. They are, however, not happy that they can't play in the garden. Henry has been making a run for it every single time the front door's been opened, and he's been getting stuck by the fence because his cone doesn't fit through the fence. No, I shouldn't laugh. I know I shouldn't, but it's hilarious. He kind of just goes, donk, and his cone, like the fence will be here by him, and his cone stops him from going forward. Once again. Yeah, Oats. Hi. Hi, my big girl. Come on. Oh, she's come to see Mammy, look. It's probably like a snazzy new collar. Snazzy. Yeah, Candy. Candy, she's ignoring me because I won't give her the chocolate I've got on the side. Look at her looking at the side, look. Why are you looking at my chocolate for? No, she's looking at me saying, "You don't need it, Mum. Give it me." She can have some of Mammy's. She's just turned her back to me. Look. I said I wouldn't give him a chocolate. You're not allowed chocolate, Andy. Odin's finally stopped chewing collars. He's got himself a snazzy new one as well. Look at that one. See it? No, he's there. Odin. Odin. You sexy boy. You mama's sexy boy. Disturbed his sleep. Yeah, he's finally learned how not to chew on collars and break them. So, they've had snazzy new collars now, and we've bought him one that he's kind of going to grow into because he's going to be a fat head, of course he is, So, I've tried to drink the 3 litres of water that the nurse has told me to drink, but I failed miserably. My fail, my bad. Which means I'm gonna struggle tomorrow. I do, however, have this. That, guys, is one of my favourite drinks going. It is orange juice, pure orange juice, and cranberry juice mixed together. Perfect balance of vitamin C and stuff to clear your system out. Then I've got a chocolate bar, a packet of pork scratchings, and a packet of Ribbon sauce crisps. I'm never gonna lose weight. I'm going to stay voluptuous and chunky for life. Oh well. You still got snazzy hair, snazzy nails, and a brilliant personality to go with it. Not everyone can say they find out they have cancer and they open their lives up to the world. And I'm quite proud of myself for that, thinking about it. A lot of people would have gone into a shell, got scared, annoyed, angry, all them emotions that I've gone through in my own little mind. And you know, to say that I haven't gone through them emotions, I'd be lying. I've gone through fear. I've gone through the why me. I'm not a bad person. I'm not a nasty person. I've never hurt anyone. I would not ever hurt anyone on purpose. Why me? I've gone through the my family don't deserve this. My children don't deserve this. I don't deserve this. I've gone through every emotion that you can think. And I thought, it's just another life lesson. It's just another hurdle. Just another shit road leading to my, I'm hoping, my very golden beach sunset cocktail in hand. Happy ever after with Mr. Ward. Let's all be serious. It's going to be a beach in Blackpool or wherever it is. With a sex in the beach on the hand while it's pissing it down underneath an umbrella. But, oh well. Can't have everything, eh? But, I've gone through all them emotions. Why me? What have I done to deserve this? And then, I'm not a deeply religious person, I'm not. But then, the old saying always comes back to me. God only gives his strongest battles to his strongest soldiers. There it is. I have been through so much shit in my life. It is unreal. And I mean that in the sense of, I don't want people to go, oh, but God, she's been through so much in her life. I've been through so much battles and I've won every single one of them. I never lose. And I never will. And I won't lose this battle. You know, I may get down on one knee, may fall, stumble, get sick, get tired. All that crap. But at the end of it, I'm going to stand on my two feet and I'm going to declare that I kicked cancer's ass, and I won. I am going to be proud of that day. That day, I'm going to pop open the bottle of champagne that my big brother Paul bought me, and I'm going to toast. And I'm going to get steaming drunk. Of course, you know. Who? It's not cheap champagne. Oh, God, no. Proper moe. One glass and I'm going to be pissed. Daddy's gone for a bath. That's why the two dogs look. That's why they're sleeping there. Cause Daddy's gone for a bath. They take full advantage when Daddy goes for a bath. Because they know, if Daddy was out now on the beer, they'd know that they could sleep there all night until Daddy got home. Because Mammy's a soft touch. If I was single, this is how my bed would be. I'd be sleeping with... They'd all be on my bed. Cats and everything would be on my bed. Mr. Ward's left his phone in the bedroom now. I'm so friggin' tempted to rape him. Very, very tempted to rape him, but I won't. I'll let him know that I didn't, though, and he's lucky. I had a good night last night. I went out with my sister-in-law. We were on Bangor. I didn't drink. Two or three very weak Archers and lemonade. Practice. We went out at 9:30, 9:45. 12:30 at night. I was on my third drink. So you think how long I took to drink all them three. But yeah, I got to meet Louie, Rex's guard dog. Guard dog, guide dog. It's beautiful. I may have found Candy a boyfriend. Don't let out any of you say that. No, he was lovely. And got to meet Rex and Steph. They were two lovely people. And you know, when you see people like that, because they're both blind. Well, I think Steph is partially blind. And you see them going through life normal, like nothing's the matter with them. It does take in perspective how lucky we are. You know, my life was the basic happy life. Children, animals, lovely house, lovely neighbours, lovely environment, lovely everything. And I get hit with this shit of a thing. And I, to begin with, I felt a bit, oh, God, what do I do? You know, I did get told when I went for my colposcopy, you know, prepare yourself for the worst, basically. So I knew from day one that I had cancer, and I'd kind of clicked that I had, you know, I was showing all the signs. I'm not a stupid woman. I would not pretend to myself that something isn't happening. Anyway, when I saw them last night, they're so in love. It was beautiful to look at, you know, and they've got everything they need with each other and their guide dog. And it just made me think how lucky we are to have the lives that we have, you know. People out there that don't have anything wrong with them, you know, look at your family, realize what you've got. You know, right now my family is stressing, worried, upset, angry. They're probably going through all the emotions. That can hurt a family. So for the people out there that have got everything, don't ever destroy it. Don't ever do anything to harm it. If you've got everything, grab it with two hands and never ever let go of it. I've got. I have got the fight of my life coming up. And I'm damn well gonna battle. And hopefully afterwards I can hopefully afterwards I can have my happy ever after that I think I so sorely deserve. Don't ever take for granted. Don't ever. You know, look at a perfect family and think that there's nothing going on. Our lives have been turned upside down, but it hasn't destroyed us, neither will it. I'm quite lucky. I was brought up by a strong woman who taught me how to be strong. don't think I could do it the way I do it otherwise. This cancer is gonna understand why it shouldn't have taken me on. But you've got to understand, people, I am gonna get weak. I'm gonna get tired. But I will. I will try and keep up with you daily. You know. I'm sorry. That kind of really got to me then. You know, after all this is done, I'm hoping to marry Daryl, and he's hoping to. It's gonna be lovely. Think after all this, I think I'm gonna deserve my happy ever after. With my doggos and my children and everything. And of course, my kitty cats. And Daryl. My telly keeps on threatening to switch itself off because I haven't put the skybox on yet. So it keeps on having some kind of hissy fit every few minutes, going, "You have 60 seconds to press a button before I switch myself off." I'm debating what to eat first, pork scratchings or knickknacks. Oh, I haven't had a good pork scratching in ages, you know. Really haven't. Just go shopping to Asda every week. And there used to be these pork scratchings that you could get. They were so puffy and nice. Oh. But I used to get them every week. I used to grab about 4 packs, 5 packs. And I used to eat them in like 2 or 3 days, and I started getting a bit thick around the waist and a bit more thicker around the waist. You know the saying, "Min on the lips, fucking a lifetime on the hips." Not joking. I keep on putting on my blogs, you know, "Please, girls, remember to go for your smears," and they're in capital letters. Like one of my friends said, "I don't want your sympathy. I do not want your pity. I want you to go and get checked out. I want you to have your smears. And I want you all to be safe. I don't want anyone to go through what I'm going through. Because although I've got all the family, all the friends I could ask for, this is the most lonely illness I've ever been through. And I have had full-blown depression. I've been through anxiety. I've been through depression separately. And I've had them both together. Now that is a lonely, very lonely illness. And this is worse. You can't talk to someone about this unless they've been through it. I'd be a liar if I said I wasn't nervous, that I wasn't scared. I'm more apprehensive, but I'm also excited to be starting the treatment. I'm more worried for Tuesday. Tomorrow is just radiotherapy. Tuesday is the. Sorry, I just have to put my phone on charge. Gone down to a lovely 5%. Joys of video recording. There we go. Tuesday's the one I'm scared for. I am worried for that. Because I am. That's when I'm getting my chemo, and I'm really scared for that. I won't lie, I'm really scared. But what can I do, eh? All I can do is grit my teeth, have everything happen, and hope for the best. On that note, I can hear Mr. Ward's bath finishing. I'm having a bath in the morning. Bath, breakfast, go. I'm tired. Very tired. I wish you all a very happy Monday. Wish you all a very successful and happy week. There's not really much more I can say other than be happy. I think tomorrow's blog is going to be quite long. We're upgrading to fibre so I can start putting longer blogs out without taking it like 4 hours to download. Or upload more like, sorry. So, I shall speak to you all tomorrow. I'll probably blog you in the car on the way. Good night. Sleep tight. Have a good Monday. Have a good week. I'm gonna get gone so I can go to sleep. Good night, everybody.